right, Miss Tammy, now make sure you save me a piece of that apple pie now.
I gotta schedule my annual physical screening thing situation. You know, I do it every year. It ain't nothing. You just go get your little checkup, and you know, that's all. A little physical. Make sure everything's good.
Doctors want me to come in for this little prostate check or whatever, but I'm not going in there. Babe, I was just at the doctor's office. Yeah. No, they didn't test me for that, but they took blood. If they need to test for that, they could use that blood they already got. I'm not going back down in there. No. Babe. Hello? Cancer?
Yeah. I don't know. Switch over there.
got that Uncle Rick Smokehouse for you, boy.
What's up with you? You ready to eat? Listen, I was down there, they had this big old dude on the fish. He tried to touch my fish with his hands. I'm like, man, I see that dirt in your nails. You better use them tongs. I ain't even want to get the fish after that, so I got you something else. But you better be glad, because boy, this right here, hee-hee! Now, you know me. Don't act like you say grace no other time. What's up with you?
What's up with you, man?
No, you know me. Trying to stay sucker-free in a world full of lollipops. You all right?
Yeah, stay free from sucker, man.
Come on, cuz. You tripping. You must have just woke up or something. Better get into this plate before I get it. You been here all day? What's wrong with you?
About 20 minutes before you called, or before you got here, bro. Doctor called. It's not good, man. It's not good.
What you mean?
Test results came back positive for cancer. For prostate cancer.
Come on. Cancer. Damn.
It's like 20 minutes before everybody called. I ain't even want to answer the phone, man. I swear I ain't want to answer it, man. Bro, I don't know what to do, man. I'm still trying to digest it, man. But they're talking about some kind of surgery or, you know, I don't know, man. I'm just trying to take it all in at this point, man. But bro, I'm scared, man. I'm scared, bro.
Damn, bro. I'm sorry to hear that. How'd you find out? Like, what happened?
Right, bro, it was just a regular checkup. You know, I get a letter in the mail from my doctor. It happens every year. Go in, go through the regular testing. Doctor called, man, it just seemed different, man. Like, I could tell. I just had this, it just felt different, man, and he broke it to me. You know, he just told me that numbers and I tested positive and surgery. I'm looking up stuff. I haven't even told my family, bro. I'ma tell my son. I'ma tell him, bro, I might not be here, man.
Nah, you're gonna be here, bro. Not even gonna talk like that. They said they're gonna do surgery. They're gonna get that up out you. You're gonna be all right. And you know, if you need anything, I got you. Your family need anything, I'm here.
I know, man.
Yeah, I know it's a tough pill to swallow, bro. But we're gonna be all right.
It's just a regular checkup, man. I get these checkups all the time, man.
Yeah. But this is the reason why you get them.
Man.
This is the reason why you get them, though.
Why me, man? Why me?
But look, imagine if you ain't get the checkup. It could have been a lot worse. You're going to be all right, man. Come on, you're a soldier, boy.
This man's just too much to deal with right now. Doctor's not saying much. He's just... I don't know what to do, man. I just, you know, I'm gonna do whatever they tell me. If they say I gotta get surgery, then, you know, I'm gonna do what I gotta do, bro. I just, I got a family support, man, but I'm scared, man. I haven't even told him. I don't know how to tell him. I don't know what I'm gonna tell my son, bro. What if surgery doesn't work?
Yeah, we're not talking like that, bro. It's gonna be good. You're gonna be good. Bro, that's crazy, man. You've been an athlete through high school and college and then this?
Bro, you gotta get tested, man. It's serious, bro. You was an athlete too, man. And that snuck up on me. I didn't expect this, man. You gotta promise me.
Bruh, I just came from the doctor. Now, they told me I was pre-diabetic, but they didn't say I had no cancer, so I'm good. If I had anything else, they'd have told me that, too. They took blood and everything.
It's different. It's different, bro. I'm sorry, but I'm not trying to... I'm just frustrated, bro.
Look, I'm worried about you, man. I understand. Bruh, full transparency. I'm scared of what those results gonna be.
You wanna be scared? And go for a checkup? You want to be dead and not even be here, bro.
Damn.
Bro, I've been looking at stuff all day, man. I just don't... Everything's different. The doctor says one thing, I'm reading something else. Just got me stressed, bro. Got me stressed.
You know, whatever you're looking at online, bro, that's like general. And with the doctor seeing you and doing whatever test they did with you, that's specifically for you. So I will go by what the doctor said, not even get caught up in that. But you can sneeze and they'll tell you that you might have some type of cancer nowadays. Don't even worry about that stuff though.
I appreciate you, man.
I got you, bro. I don't even know what to say. Just know that I'm here for you. If you need anything, I got you.
So relieved. I'm glad that I got the procedure because they caught it in time. Yeah. They caught it in time, so... It's we're on the other side of the field now. We're on the home stretch. And Jay should be here to get me in the next few minutes. Yeah. Just make sure you got something good to eat because I'm hungry. I haven't eaten because we had the fast prior to the procedure. All right, I love you. All right, bye-bye.
What's up with you, youngin? What's good? Oh, boy, I still got it, and I'll tell you now. Look at that right there. Smack him. Let me see what you got, boy. Get it. Okay, all right. I'm gonna swing around a little bit.
Proud of you, little man. You've been stepping up. I know you've been concerned about me. I know you've been concerned about some of the things you've been hearing, but I'm good. The procedure went good. And I'm here, you know, I'm not leaving you, man. You're your mom, I ain't going nowhere. I know you've been concerned and everything, but I'm here with you, man. All right, and I know you is ready to step up and hold the house down, but you don't gotta do that right now, all right? Just keep making me proud, man. You do good in school, and grades good, and do your thing on the court. Love you, boy. But do your thing, man. Let me see what you got out there, man. I'm right behind you, man. Let's go, baby.
Show him what I taught you, man. And the drive. Yep, hit it. Boom! Look, Young boy remind me of me when I was young, boy.
Oh,
I'm
man,
telling
that's
you.
Good. I used to beat on you, too.
My youngin', what's up with you?
Come on, man.
You know your boy out here showing off a little bit, man.
Hey, good, I'm baby. Glad you out here, period.
Yeah,
how you feel?
Bruh, I feel great.
Okay.
I mean, bruh, I'm out here, man. I didn't expect it to be like this, man. I had all these different thoughts and concerns about what it could possibly be
right
after the surgery. I feel amazing.
That's
bro.
What's up. How you feel? Amazing. How your stomach and everything feel? I heard your core be messed up sometimes.
You know, it's a little bit like it's still, you know, getting some used to and some, you know, building some muscles back up. But that's anything without, you know, after any procedure, you know, anytime following any procedure, you're going to have some different things you got to build back up.
Damn.
You know what I mean?
I'm scared. I don't like no surgery. I don't like people cutting on me. I don't even want to. That test, bro, I don't want nobody, no doctor putting their finger up my, you know what I mean? You know what I'm saying?
Ah! So I tell you what, man, that obviously was a concern of mine, too. But I said, have a blood test that they can do it now, too.
Okay.
You know? And there's just different ways. The biggest thing is that, catch it. Gotta catch it. And I was fortunate enough, thank you God, to be able to catch it.
Yeah.
Doctors caught it, and they performed the surgery in time enough to be able to let me live a normal life
right.
afterwards.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
But that's the thing, man. Like, that whole normal life, man, they talk about you might have to wear diapers. They talk about your soldier won't stand up. Man, I'm like, come on, man. I can't live like that, bro.
Yeah, but you'll be living.
Yeah.
That's the key. You'll be living.
You said
right?
that because everything was good with your surgery. You know what I mean?
You know, man, but at the end of the day, though, again, though, you, at least you're here.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And that's the thing. Like, the biggest thing I was concerned about is, you know, I got a lot of people who look up to me. You know, a lot of people who
yeah,
need me. You
facts.
Know, that's my young boy
yeah,
right
this
there, man.
One dude I was talking to last week said the same thing. He was like, man, you got a lot to live for. And I told him, like, you know, I ain't want this and that. He was like, would you rather be uncomfortable and live, or would you rather be comfortable and die? I was like, dang.
With the young, what y'all say, youngin'? Facts?
Facts.
That's what
yeah.
that is right there.
Absolutely.
Right?
So that made me think about it, man. So I've been contemplating it. I just, you know, just kind of leery about it. You feel me?
It's okay. Listen, go do it. All right? I support you in any way. All right?
All right.
But you gotta get it done.
Yeah,
you got a lot
right.
to live for,
I
bro.
Do.
Gotta
I
go.
Do. You're right.
Gotta
I'm
go.
Gonna do it.
James, I'm glad that you was able to make this teleconference today because there's some really important things I'd like to discuss with you today. How are you feeling?
I'm doing pretty good. How you doing today, Doc?
Oh, I'm doing good. Anytime I wake up, son, I'm doing good. What I want to discuss is your recent PSA test results. So your PSA level is actually 6.0. Now, what does that mean? Normal is less than 0.1 to 4.0. So yours isn't really that bad. I've seen PSAs up in the teens and the 20s. Okay, unfortunately, we as African American men, we do not discuss certain things at home. I know a gentleman who had prostate cancer, and until he found out he had prostate cancer, his father had it, his brother had it, all three of his uncles had it. That's something that we, unfortunately, as African-American men do not discuss. And then, unfortunately, we as African-American men don't go to the doctor until something is wrong. We, as black men, start taking charge of our own health. Well, prostate cancer for so long has been in the closet, bro. And it's time to bring it out of the closet.